dream has always been for a public transport network that is just so good that no matter where you live in our region, you can get around easily and affordably without needing to own a car.
Buses are so important because they're the bits, they're the veins that get out into our communities that link everybody up. Bus Regulation the Musical, inspired by Andrew Lloyd Webber's Starlight Express, but instead of portraying trains, they're buses, tell the story of public transport policy from the post-war period up to the present day and going into the future.
I worked as a bus conductress for Glasgow Corporation Transport in the 1950s and 60s.
The main character of the musical is Nellie the Clippie. There were lots of women that worked as bus conductresses, and she's kind of narrating us through this almost really tragic history of the little strides towards an integrated system that were made.
On 1st of June 1973, the Greater Glasgow Passenger Transport Executive was formed, or GGPTE for short. It inherited 1,300 buses for Glasgow Corporation, as well as the subway.
Our buses in Glasgow have been run into the ground for the last 40 years, since the buses were deregulated in 1986. Decisions that have been made in the past are completely nonsensical. And if you can see that played out, you realise that is no way to run a public transport system.
SPG buses piled into the city centre to make the most of lucrative routes. Dirty tactics were rife, with operators blocking bus stops or running just in front of the others to pick up passengers first.
In the 1990s, you go from having all of these different colourful companies, and then of course they start merging and getting taken over, and gradually by the end of the 90s, you've literally just got about three big multinational companies that own the whole show. And then we're getting into trouble because that's when they start cranking the prices up.
By the start of the new millennium, it was clear. The big bus businesses ruled the show. They cut all routes which they didn't consider commercially viable, and they hiked up the fares on all those remaining. It was pushing people into poverty, and it was a disaster for our climate.
Transport policy has not been acting in our interests for the last 30 years. We need to turn that around. We need to say to our politicians, look, we really want this to work. We want an integrated public transport system. For God's sake, sort it out.
We can't afford to waste any more time. Let's get everyone using public transport to tackle the climate emergency. And let's create thousands of new green jobs running our world-class service. Oh, we could even bring back the Clippies.